Hockey Night in Canada continues here while the goals are coming in this Battle of Alberta, the 226th time tonight, the 226th time that these two franchises have met up. It has been, it seems like a lifetime since both teams were in the playoffs at the same time. But you can see there's lots of hope for a rejuvenated Battle of Alberta.
The Edmonton Oilers would like to select with their first pick.
I'm more annoyed about the process. You know, this is not a way hockey teams were meant to be assembled. This isn't right.
From the Erie Otters, Connor McDavid.
This notion of picking first repeatedly, we've got to address that system. That being said, it was within the rules. This is the team they have now, and it's a team we're going to have to beat. So we've assembled our team a little different way. I would never want to do it the way that it's been done north of here, but let the rivalry begin.
The fans are standing and cheering as they watch this slugfest.
You always hear stories about the Battle of Alberta.
I think going to Calgary or Calgary coming here is always going to be a fun game. It's always a good battle.
Every year that I've been here, it's been getting more and more intense between the players.
As an Oiler and as someone that's part of this community, you have a certain amount of animosity towards Calgary.
The Battle of Alberta continuing early in this one.
This rivalry spawned in Alberta 35 years ago.
The Battle of Alberta historically has been great for this province, and it's been great for the National Hockey League. This was a case where, you know, you had a nuclear arms race at one point where Edmonton under Glenn Sather had assembled this magical cast of players. And Cliff Fletcher here as the general manager was keeping pace in the arms race, and you had great physical battles and great divisional standings battles, and it was a real Battle of Alberta and engaged the fans in the province. It was magical even from the outside watching it.
For eight consecutive years between 1983 and 1990, either the Oilers or the Flames were in the Stanley Cup final.
Wayne Gretzky in on goal, just scores in overtime.
And of all of Wayne Gretzky's NHL goals, his personal favorite was an overtime winner against the Flames, capped off by a Glenn Sather salute to the crowd in Calgary.
There was a real hate on for each other. I know it's a really strong word, but both teams disliked each other, and it went from the coaching staff right down to the players.
We respected them, but certainly didn't like them. Well, sticks are up. We're trying to hit people and hit people with a purpose.
For a number of years there, it was the most fierce rivalry in hockey because both teams could play any which way you wanted to play.
There's a breakaway for Messier. Messier going in, he scores!
The rivalry lives on, but it's lost some of its shine over the past two decades. The Oilers haven't been in the playoffs in 9 years. In fact, Calgary and Edmonton haven't faced off in the playoffs since 1991.
Any good rivalry, you need to have two successful teams. I mean, it doesn't matter, you know, which rivalry it is. It's going to be at its best when you're fighting for playoff spots or when you're meeting in the playoffs.
Here comes Gaudreau, works through in there!
Well, I think with Calgary taking a step last year and making the playoffs and having a pretty good team, and us, you know, on the rise, I'd like to think, you know, we could, you know, ignite that. I think it would be great.
Last season, it wasn't very exciting. I think we won every game, but, you know, this season, I think it's going to bring a little bit more hype to it.
This new hype was generated by the Oilers selecting Connor McDavid.
You should be very proud of yourself. This is awesome. Welcome to the NHL.
Thank you.
And it's McDavid and his childhood friend, Flames first-rounder Sam Bennett, who could help lead the resurgence of this once spectacular rivalry.
Knowing each other since we were 8 years old, and you know, to be playing against each other in the NHL is pretty cool. He's a really good friend of mine, and I'm excited to play against him. It'll be cool to see him out there. So the game's all about is you know, that intensity, and you know, Battle of Alberta brings that out. So I'm certainly excited to play in it.